Hello everyone, my name is Ron Z. Welcome back to another episode of Cold Start, and today we're looking at the 2019 Honda Civic. Let's roll the clip. Welcome back everyone. Hope you all enjoyed the cinematic we did for the 2019 Honda Civic. Now this Civic did receive a mid-generation refresh with some changes to the bumpers, interior and exterior. I mean, looking at the front, you can notice some changes to the front bumper, especially on the lower end, with more sporty and more aggressive accent with the black splitter right here added on the new bumper. And of course the middle is finished with a piano black with the Honda badge in the center. Very, very nice. Moving at the rear side or the mid side of the vehicle, you can notice a 16-inch aluminum alloy wheels with an option of 18-inch aluminum alloy wheel with a Touring trim level. Now this trim level we're looking at today is the EX trim level. Touring is available here in 2019, maybe January, February, but we want to bring the car to you guys as soon as possible. Another exciting feature on the EX or the 2019 model of the Civic is brand new color. We have a cosmic blue here, kind of like a dark blue with mixed with black or grayish. And moving at the rear side of the vehicle, you can notice one of the most convenient things that I really like, capless fuel tanks. I love it when manufacturers give convenience to their consumers. And moving at the rear side of the bumper, you can notice some nice groove lines over here, kind of resembled an embedded spoiler, giving that more added sportiness and aggressive accent to the Honda Civic. Opening the trunk is actually quite spacious. I really like how the trunk is very deep and a little bit tall as well. So as you can see, we fit all of our filming equipment in the rear trunk of the Civic. Pretty spacious, and of course, as a day-to-day commuter vehicle, I definitely see why Honda Civic was, or still is, the number one best-selling vehicle here in Canada, giving you a value of 26 grand for a brand new car. This good-looking, reliability, safety, styling, and performance all packed together in the 2019 Honda Civic. Now, let's take a look at the interior of the Honda Civic. Stepping inside, the first thing I did notice is that this car is equipped with cloth seats because we're at the EX trim level. If you want to go with leather, you can do that in the Touring trim level. We do have power adjustable seats, dual zone climate control, heated seat, and what's new, what's really exciting, this might sound silly, is that we have a volume knob button. The previous generation is the touchscreen, which slides up and down. I feel like you didn't get the right amount of volume because it's so sensitive, and I think with the volume knob over here, you can get exact volume of where you're looking for. And looking up ahead, this design over here kind of follows the Honda Accord with the buttons over here. And this car is equipped with rear view camera, but not navigation. Once again, navigation is in the Touring trim level. Looking up ahead, you have your sunroof. And over here, we have this aluminum brushed trim over here. Very nice accent to it. But what's really exciting is this little compartment over here that you can store your phone. But what's really interesting is that you can feed through the wire over here and you can lock it in so your phone can stay nicely snug on this panel over here, so you're not too distracted, and the wire feed pretty flawlessly, so there's not too much disruptions for you to connect from your USB to your phone as well. Overall, center compartment, you can fit two cups over here, and you can maneuver as well, pretty spacious, and you can slide this up and down to fit whatever your configuration want. But I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's go for a drive. Now we're driving on 401 East on the highway, and the pickup speed on this car is actually not too bad. Of course, we have a 2.0 liter naturally aspirated engine, giving you 158 horsepower. That's okay, it's not too bad, but then again, you have enough speed for an everyday vehicle. And the first thing I noticed after getting inside the vehicle is how stiff the steering is. It definitely lots different than the previous years. Toronto or the GTA does have a lot of potholes and uneven pavement, and gives you the reassurance that if you go over uneven pavement, you have full control of the vehicle. I currently have the lane keep assist on. It's not too intrusive. And one great thing about Honda is that every time you change lanes to the right, of course, and you signal, you have a lane changing camera. Very, very nice. I think that's a very good feature, very good safety feature, just in case your blind spot is covered or whatever, you can't see. And they have that on a lot of the platform in the Honda vehicles as well. Now, the transmission in this car is a CVT transmission for the simple orientation that we want to have better fuel economy. For me, I've owned a CVT transmission vehicle. After it gets to about, 80,000 kilometers, 100,000 kilometers, it becomes very, very noisy. I wasn't a big fan of it, but I do think that with the technology nowadays, they refined it, retuned the CVT transmission to make it a lot more enjoyable. For me, I still prefer a 6-speed automatic or 7-speed automatic. Personal preference, obviously. Of course, once you have a 6-speed, 7-speed, you can have the paddle shifter there as well for the added pleasure or added sporty pleasure of the vehicle. And driving this car, overall feeling, I do like it a lot. The suspension is a little bit stiffer than the average car, but with a little bit stiffer suspension, you get better cornering, better handling overall. And there are some small body rolls once you turn left or turn right. If you do that more aggressively, we want to exit into the local street and see how this car handles on the street with its suspension. But overall feeling, very enjoyable. I think this car is probably one of the better options to have as your day-to-day vehicle, especially with its exterior styling, interior styling, and the technology on this car does react quicker than the average car on the market. And looking up ahead, you do have your green zone. There's some lights that light up green, and that shows that your fuel economy is at its most optimal settings right now. When you put your foot on the throttle, it becomes like a light greenish, knowing that your fuel economy isn't as great. But once you're cruising, once you're set at a certain speed, it becomes green again, and then the car allows you know that, hey, this car is performing at the most optimal fuel economy or fuel efficiency, pairing that with the transmission and the engine as well. That was some rough patch road, and then the car kind of had a little bit dips here and there, but the suspension actually feels quite nice on this car. And I think for a day-to-day car, this car is does that make sense? We're gonna enter some rough corners. I guess my body kind of rolls a little bit, but I'm not going to compare this to a sports car or whatever, or how stiff the suspension is. There are other additional features here and there, dual zone climate control, sunroof. For me, I don't really mind if my car has a sunroof or not. Overall, very nice. And we're going to cut into some rolling shots so you guys can enjoy the car. So that's it for me today, guys. I hope you all enjoyed the review and the cinematic we did for the 2019 Honda Civic. I want to give a quick thank you to Whippy Austral Honda for letting us experience this brand new car. Thank you guys so much. Make sure you slap that like, subscribe, and comment which features and highlights that you really enjoy in this car that I may have missed. My name is Ron Z, and I will see you on a brand new episode of Cold Start next Saturday.